In the wake of Saturday's big storm, a storm that left a path of destruction in North Idaho and North Spokane.
Major damage was trees. We lost 23 trees, some of them well over 80, 85 years old.
Well, trees came down all over at the Holy Cross Cemetery in North Spokane. It was shut down for a few days so crews could clean up those trees and repair some of the headstones that were damaged. No buildings were damaged and no headstones disturbed, but the cemetery will likely be closed tomorrow as well. And tonight, thousands remain without power. KXY4's Allie Norton joins us live at Avista. And Allie, sounds like there's still a lot of work to do.
On both ends, Nadine, Avista has restored power to about 92% of their customers. And the good news is that they expect to have most of the power restored to their customers later tonight. Now, with that being said, crews are still working hard. And while they're doing that, the community is working to clean up the debris from Saturday night's storm.
The rain started coming in. It was like a giant wave of water just coming through. And as trying to watch, and you could just see the trees just snapping right off.
In this Deer Park neighborhood, power lines are down. Trees lay belly up. It's a similar scene they just saw a handful of days ago.
A big red fir that fell down took the power lines down the first storm.
At Arthur Frisbee's house, power had only been on for 5 days before they lost it again.
It's been really tough. You know, all this, the no power just, you know, drives you a little crazy.
Crews are working around the clock to get it restored.
Well, we just appreciate the patience of our customers. It's really unprecedented to have Mother Nature just really take a whack at us twice in 10 days.
In the meantime, generators are the key to normal living.
Right now, he's just got it set up for one room so we can keep track with the news and such like that.
This house took a bigger hit than most. On top of not having power, it's missing the roof to the living room. A tree snapped in half and fell on it during the first storm.
All we did was just pull everything out. It's piled up right out there.
Joy James is looking after the house owned by 90-year-old Bertie Reese. She says they finished cleaning the yard when the second storm hit. Luckily, no one was injured.
Well, you know what? You pick up, you brush off, and you carry on. And that's what we will do.
And there are still outages to report tonight. Avista saying that there's 3,000 customers without power right now, 4,000 for Inland Power, and 1,700 for Northern Light customers. Now, there is good news in all of this. The city of Spokane is going to offer their free green collection again like they did for the last storm. If you have any, like, tree clippings or pine needles, the smaller stuff that is clean green, you can start dropping it off at the North County Transfer Station or the waste-to-energy facility starting tomorrow. Reporting in Spokane, I'm Allie Norton, KXLY 4 News.